Hello and welcome to my channel. In this tutorial, I would like to show how I created this burning fire text animation. Let's see the preview. Before getting into this topic, I would like to thank you for being here and supporting me. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. Also click on the bell icon so that you get notified as soon as I post videos. Please watch the video completely. Don't skip the video. Let's not waste any more of the time. Let's get started. To create this effect, I have imported two image files and a particle stock video file. Create a new composition and name the composition as main. I have chosen a 1920x1080 composition with the frame rate of 30 and a duration of 6 seconds. Create a new text layer and type in your text. I am typing in subscribe. Align the text to the center of the composition. Bring in the texture file into the timeline and change the track mat to alpha mat subscribe text layer. Go to the effects and presets panel and search for curves and apply it onto the texture layer. Change the curves as shown. Select the two layers and right click and click on pre-compose. Name the composition as text and click on move all attributes and click OK. Go to the project panel and bring in the background image into the main composition. Apply the curves effect to the background image also. Change the curves as shown. Go to the text composition and select texture image. Go to the effects and presets panel and search for tint effect and apply it into the texture image. Change the color as you like. Also change the curves according to the color you have chosen. Copy the text from the text composition and paste it into the main composition. Create a new solid layer and name it as Saber. Go to the effects and presets panel and search for Saber effect and apply it into the Saber solid layer. Change the preset to fire, glow intensity, the glow spread around 0.14 and set the glow bias around 0.5. In the customize core, set the core type to text layer and in the text layer, select subscribe. Set the end size and the end offset value to 0. Also set the start size to 0%. At the start of the timeline, create a keyframe for end offset with 0%. At around 6 frames, set the end offset value to 80%. At 6 frames mark, create a keyframe for start offset and start size with 0%. Go to 2 second mark and set the start size to 80%. Set the start offset to 40%. Go to the render settings and change the composite settings to transparent. Set the blending mode to hard light. Search for tint effect and apply it into the background layer. I am making the background much more darker. So I am changing the map white to color to gray color. Duplicate the text composition and move it above the Saber layer. Set the blending mode to soft light. Search for bevel alpha effect from the effects and presets panel and apply it into the duplicated text layer. Set the light intensity to 1 and edge thickness to 5. Still, I am not satisfied with the background color, so I am changing the map white to color to something around dark red. Bring in the particle footage file into the timeline and set the blending mode to add. search for curves effect from the effects and presets panel and apply it into the particle layer. Change the curves as shown. Now ramp preview this. Create a new camera layer. Also create a null object. Make all the layers 3D. Parent the camera 1-2, null 1 layer. Press P to bring up the position property of the null 1 layer. At around 1 second mark, create a keyframe with the default position values. At the start of the timeline, set the Z value so high, somewhere around 2000. Now ramp preview this. That's good. That's it. Hope you enjoyed this video. Let's see the output once again. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and also click on the bell icon so that you get notified as soon as I post the videos. Click on the like button and share it with your friends. Comment down if you have anything to ask. And once again, thanks for being here and supporting me. This is Raudran signing off.